Tommy, did you hear his Michael Jackson story?
Nah.
Tell him, were you after the show? What did he tell you?
I just beat Sphinx. Biggest fight in the world. Yep. So I'm in Cleveland, Michael performing in Cleveland. So I'm there with Don King. So he gets in Cleveland, we go for Michael Jackson. So let's go. And so he's telling me all the relationships he had with Mike. He had him promoted their tour and all that. So we went to the concert. We came into the front door, and as you know, we're walking down the aisle to go backstage. We came from the last song. And as soon as we finished the song, we saw Don King going like this, and Mike went like this. And so I went like this, and Mike put his hand down. So I said, oh, he couldn't have been dissing me because he don't play his number that well. I came backstage, and everybody was talking to me, someone gave me the drumsticks. And they were nothing to fuss with. They won a big fight. You know, Michael's at the door. The door's open, but Michael's sitting down like this. And I'm thinking, well, he's waiting for a car to come, so I better go over and say hi to him. I have never met him yet. And I go like this. Stay with you where you're at. I said, how you doing? He said, who do I know you from? I know you from somewhere. I didn't know I'm Michael Jackson. I just wanted to meet you.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Did you ever meet him again after that?
Yeah.
And he knew who you were then.
He knew that he just busted my boy.
Oh, he was your boy, yeah.
Then, after, right?
At the end of pretty much his career, and he pretty depressed back there and knew all that shit was out. So a friend of mine that produces that said, hey man, come out here with Mike. I said, fuck that, I'm not going, he dissed me. He said, nah, Mike wanna see you. That's really? He got me right away. I came there, I got to know him, and it was awesome. Cool.
Yeah. You go up listening to him too, Michael Jackson?
I was all with it.
Yeah.
We were 10 years old, 12 years old.
Did he give you any advice or anything?
Huh?
Give you any?
Get sleep. He said, sleep. I didn't know this motherfucker couldn't sleep.
True.
I had no idea he couldn't get me. He couldn't sleep. He said, rest is good. I said, me, it's resting. He said, rest is good. Wow. Remember, rest is good.
Yeah. Well, I asked Mike about recovery before, because you know there's all kinds of fancy stuff that the athletes do nowadays. I said, what'd you do about recovery? He's like, what do you mean? Like, sleep a lot. You said you barely slept, right?
I don't sleep much.
Yeah, all throughout your career?
Too nervous.
Crazy, right?
Yeah. I get up in the middle of the night, and at 3 in the morning, I call my trainer, bring the meds over.
Wow.
Go ahead, meds.
Yeah.
Be in the bed, can't sleep, nervous, fight the next day. Yeah.
That's like Floyd running at 3 in the morning all the time, right?
Yeah.
But he trains at night because he fights at night.
That's smart. That's smart. Yeah, but to be adaptive.
That's probably, it's only smart to him psychologically. You know? Mm-hmm. I mean, when it's time to fight, we're fighting. Yeah. Okay, what time is it? Yeah. What time in the clock? What time in the world? A fight's a fight. Knowing you're going to get your ass kicked if you don't fight because of some particular hour would be nerve-wracking.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah.
I always trained in the day, and I trained strength and conditioning at night.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I mean, if he's telling himself, I train at night, that's because I fight at night. It's giving him that confidence. Like you told me, confidence breeds success. Success breeds confidence, right? Yeah, makes sense. So do you want to go hit the bag and get this done for Mike so that you can get out of the way?
Let's do it. I'm going to Mike to work. I'm going to knock out with him.
PJ? Okay. Yeah, I'm still here. Okay.
Maybe. Still rolling out. Crazy, right, Mike?
What are you asking, Dre?
Said they're all fighting for the belt.
This today, too many belts in boxing. Very watered down.
You need the belt because every time they hear a championship fight, people want the belt.
Yeah,
that's why they make so many belts. Look, imagine a guy like Henry Armstrong. He got to spear the belt simultaneously. I want a guy to come down and fight this. Like this.
Hey Mike, one of these posters, one of these pieces of paper here is not like the other. Where is it? Where is it? I'm trying to find it. Oh, right there. There's a little Easter egg in there with Kennedy. Crazy, right? Crazy, man. I had to throw that in there just as a little Easter egg.
to your fight?
Well, Trump would always go to his fight.
He promoted my fight.
When they were in office?
Kennedy's son was your boy, though, right?
Yeah, he came to my fight.
John Jr., yeah. And then I saw your interview on your podcast with Robert Kennedy Jr. I thought that was awesome. That was awesome. I really enjoyed that one.
Yeah. I didn't want to say most of the things I wanted to say.
Of course.
Ellie Sekback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.